Young man, name your reward, and you shall have it for saving my daughter.
Well, I'm hungry.
Not a bad bargain for only 25 cents.
Pokey, you're gonna change into a pig.
I love you. rain spirits look like, little Hobie?
They look like my Kachina doll I received from Dibber Kachina. I was tasting one of these icicles, and it fell down.
Those aren't icicles, Pokey. Those hanging up there are stalactites, and those on the floor are stalagmites. They are limestone deposited by water dripping from the ceiling for hundreds of years.
Oh.
Rain spirit must be in here. I hear sound.
Help! I'm stuck!
Look! Falling water!
Wow! What a waterfall!
Well, the rain spirits can't be far away now. Come on!
Wait, I hear voice. Come, quiet.
Aren't you going to ask them?
I afraid.
Gumby, let's get out of here.
Do not be afraid. We know you came here for help. What is it you want?
My people starve. We tried to raise corn and pumpkin. But earth is too dry. I ask mighty rain spirit for rain. Please.
Are you obedient to your father and mother?
Yes.
We bring your people rain. But you must promise to place first ear of corn on high rock. Then our messenger, Thunderbird, bring it to us.
I promise.
I'm getting out of here.
Gumby, I'm seeing things again.
That corn maiden Kachina. She make corn grow. Watch.
Say, that looks good. Let's eat some.
Wait. I made promise to rain spirit.
Oh, I forgot.
Kachinas are sure fine spirits.
Now we watch for Thunderbird. People not starve.
Now we can go back to our swimming pool, Gumby.
Hobie, may we help you pick the corn?
You very kind. Basket, over here. Now you like swim in my pool? Follow me.
Oh,
and pull. Whippercagina, punish Flying Stone for disobedience.
Hi, Mr. Zookeeper. Where's the lion today?
My finest, most ferocious lion got sick and died suddenly.
Sure wish I could help you. Hi, Pokey. What are you looking at?
Rubies.
Rubies? This isn't a jewelry store.
No, Groobies. G-R-O-O-B-E-E-S.
Oh? But what are Groobies, anyway?
Oh, my dear boy. You mean to say you've never seen a Groobie? Duh, don't move, my boy. I'll give you a demonstration right here.
Better crank up your sales resistance quick.
Don't worry. He couldn't sell me anything in 1,000 years.
Now, my friends, stand back of the cage and I'll show you what Groobies do. You see that dog over there? Now, suppose you'd like to catch that dog. All you do is face the cage in that direction and open the cage door like this. Now, to get him back in his cage, you merely blow the special ultrasonic whistle.
Wow! That's some bee!
Yes, sir. The Groobie doesn't build honeycombs like other bees. He builds crates around other animals.
Any animals?
Yes, sir. Any animal alive.
How much are the Groobies?
Only $2.50 apiece.
I'll take one. It's just what I need. What do you feed a Groobie?
Just sawdust and nails.
Now maybe you can tell me why we're way out in the middle of an African jungle like this.
Our zookeeper needs a lion. You wouldn't want to see a zoo without a lion, would you?
No. If it's anything I can't stand, it's a zoo without lions.
So, I thought we could catch some and give them to the zookeeper.
Catch some?
Now, Pokey, you take the whistle and wait right here. I'll go out and draw some lions into the open. Then, when I yell your name, you open the cage quickly. You got it?
Yeah. But you're sure the Groobies worked on lions?
If it doesn't, I get my money back.
For some strange reason, I can't see much comfort in money when I'm inside a lion's stomach.
Yipes! I hit the jackpot! Pokey!
Can't see Gumby anywhere in that tall grass. But he said to open it, so here goes. Go get the lion, Groobie, old boy. One, two, three lions. Uh-oh. Good work, Groobie. You deserve an extra portion of sawdust and nails for dinner tonight. Where are you, Gumby?
I'm in here. Bring a hammer.
Hey!
you how he did it.
Well, I couldn't have done it without my friend, Pokey. Pokey, will you step forward and bring the Groovy cage?
Me?
Quick, Pokey, where is the whistle?
There on the chair.